Good morning, my brothers and sisters. May you bow with me as we pray together. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Indeed, God, it is in your name that we humbly come before your throne of grace this morning, with thanksgiving in our hearts, because of your abound love that you lavished on us through your Son, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who died on the cross to redeem us and rose again to give us life everlasting. It is with this confidence that we can approach you, our God and Father, with joy in our hearts. We acknowledge your presence in our lives through the Holy Spirit. Thank you, God, for your divine protection upon our lives. Thank you for keeping us safe and healthy in this difficult time where the whole world is under fear and panic because of the COVID-19 pandemic. We thank you for technology that we can meet online and hear you speaking into our hearts through your divine word. We thank you, God, that you are calling many people across the world to know you, especially at this difficult time. Thank you, Jesus, for revealing your salvific power to those who are in the darkness, that they may see your light and find rest in you alone. We thank you for St. Barnabas Church, a place that nurtures us and a place where we find a spiritual growth. Bless the ministry of your word in St. Barnabas, especially the Kingdom Kids, Building on the Rock, and the WDYE program, so that through these ministries, many may come to know you and have a personal relationship with you, Jesus. Bless our Pastor Simon as he takes us through the series in Mark's Gospel. Give him a spirit of clarity as he devotes himself for the service of the Gospel. Bless all our church members, all the members and associate members, and also remember the St. Barnabas alumni as they partner in the Gospel. Bless the President of South Africa, Cyril Ramaphosa, and all the African presidents. Give them wisdom and godly fear that they will administer justice in all the African countries. We remember our fellow brothers and sisters in the Lord who are being persecuted because of their faith. Give courage and strength and everlasting hope in you, O God, our Father and our King. We remember all the GWC students. We thank you for calling them into ministry. Therefore, we also pray for the spirit of wisdom and understanding. We pray for the third years and the high certificate students as they are looking forward to their graduation this year. Please, Lord, we pray that may they cross successfully. We also pray for our family members across Africa and diaspora, that keep them safe and reveal yourself, O Lord, to them, especially to those who did not know you yet. We ask all this through faith in Jesus' name. Amen.